Hey guys, welcome to my channel. I am so excited and a little emotional to do this video for you. 1 year ago today, I did not expect to be sitting here sharing my fitness story with everyone. So we're just gonna go ahead and jump right on into it. It's hard to believe it myself. One whole year has passed. It doesn't seem like it's been that long, but my transformation photos astound me. I can't believe what I've accomplished in 1 year. I ask myself every day why I didn't do this sooner, why I didn't stick with it long enough to find out that it was going to become my passion, that it would change my life, that it would be all I think about, and that it would have so many doors open up into the future. This is my story about my fitness journey. I grew up very athletic and blessed with a fast metabolism. I never even considered myself overweight or even close. I've learned when you get into your 20s, your metabolism starts to slow down. And when you're not active anymore, you tend to put the weight on. From the middle of college up until about a year ago, I had put on way more weight than I had liked, and it seemed that it got worse the older I got. I tried dieting and exercising. I tried everything that would lead me to a quick fix because I wanted the weight off right now. I didn't want to wait. I had seen all the ads on TV where it said you can lose 20 pounds in a month, so I thought crash dieting was for me. Turns out, every time I did a crash diet, I would gain all my weight back and more. I never really considered myself, you know, really fat. I understood that there was people in this world that was worse off than myself. However, that didn't make the bad feeling I had about my body image go away. I've never had a good relationship with my body image. I've always been a little self-conscious about my body, and when I started gaining weight, that self-conscious got worse. Now, believe me, I truly understand that I was more fortunate than other people in this world, but again, we all have our own battles no matter where we've started from. I was unhappy with myself. I felt fat. I felt like I wasn't pretty. I felt like that I couldn't be sexy. And I didn't have a lot of confidence, although sometimes it may seem like I did. I got to the point where I would wear bigger shirts to hide my belly pooch. I would wear tank tops under all my shirts just so it would like hide my love handles and my lower belly that stuck out. I would stand in front of a mirror picking myself apart, telling myself that my thighs were too big, that my stomach stuck out too far, that my love handles had completely gotten away from me. And I would ask myself, how did I let myself get like this? This is when I started crash dieting, trying to lose as much weight as I could as fast as I could. It never really worked for me though. I would restrict almost everything. I don't mean starve myself. I mean, I would cut out almost everything, you know, unhealthy and bad for you. I tried, and when I say I tried, I half-assed it. I've tried the Atkins diet. I did like the Special K thing. I tried everything healthy. Cutting carbs, just everything, but nothing worked for me. I went about it all wrong. I didn't worry about protein. I didn't worry about the different kinds of fats, dairy, or carbs. I just didn't understand how to properly diet for the body I wanted. All I knew is what I had seen and we see on TV every day. You can lose 20 pounds in a month. You can lose 10 pounds in 3 days. You can lose weight and you don't even have to exercise. All these are crash diets and none of them are sustainable for a day-to-day life. I knew none of this at the time and I never even thought to pick up a nutrition book or find a reliable website to learn and teach myself how I could reach my goals. Now, here's a little background story of things leading up until my fitness journey actually started a year ago. And the reason why I want to share this with you is because you'll see just how many times I tried and how many times I failed. My journey to get my ideal body officially started, or when I actually remember starting it, was July of 2013. Copeland and I had joined the gym in our hometown. He wasn't traveling for work at this time. And although I didn't know how to properly diet, I have always had a little bit of knowledge with gym equipment and just exercising. I also had the opportunity to try Herbalife. I would take the Herbalife shakes, for a meal, and I would never eat breakfast. I was working out long and hard in the evenings, and my workout routines were very similar to what I do today. I put myself in a very low caloric deficiency, mostly eating 1,000 calories or less. I didn't really track the calories. At first, I seen results and I was excited and happy that my stomach had gotten smaller. I had gained muscle. But because I was lifting so heavy, of course I was going to gain muscle. But what I didn't realize at the time is that I was actually losing muscle mass at the same time with my fat loss because my calories were so low. And nothing crazy what I'm about to say. I actually started traveling with Copeland 24/7 at this point, and this is basically when I become a stay-at-home lady, housewife, whatever you want to call it, and everything was so new to me. I was living like 900 miles away from home in a camper, and the only person I knew was Copeland. A new town, a new everything to me. I was excited and scared at the same time. I knew that I wanted to get back into the gym once I had settled into my new living environments. So that's when I joined Anytime Fitness. I signed up for a personal trainer. Like I said, I've always had a little knowledge about the gym, but getting a personal trainer I thought would help me reach my goals faster, and that I would learn a little bit of new things in the gym. My personal trainer was awesome. He pushed me to my limits during my workout, but my problem here wasn't in the gym. It was what happened outside the gym. My trainer and I talked about nutrition, but he never really went into the depths of it, and I never asked questions. Since my 30-minute sessions were so intense, 3 to 4 days a week, kind of thought I could eat whatever I want and the exercising would balance it out. And I continued this routine until Christmas of that year. After that, we started traveling back and forth to Oklahoma, to Indiana, quite a bit from Copeland getting time off and us just wanting to spend time with family. So I got out of the routine of working out and would only work out, just a little bit while I was in Indiana. I think I did this all the way up until May of the next year in 2014. After May, Copeland was off for a little bit, and I got out of the routine of, dieting and exercising. I guess since I hadn't got much results from my personal trainer and the times that, the gym time that I spent in Indiana, I kind of just gave up. I just quit everything. I felt like I was just spinning my wheels because my diet wasn't on point and I had ate whatever I wanted. So this basically led to me giving up and gaining my weight back and more. We eventually went back to work in Texas, and the town that we were in was very decent. I'm sure it had a gym in it, or gyms. It was pretty big. But I was still out of the routine of not exercising, not eating healthy. So, I didn't want to try. It felt like it was too hard. I told myself that I needed to accept my body, that I wasn't that big. But in the back of my mind, I still wanted that ideal body. I decided I needed to start working out again. So, of course, I decided this when we were in a town that had no gym. It was tiny. I started walking / jogging, and this is when I learned that I was not a runner. I hated it. I would get up early and head down the sidewalk that our little town had. I would go to the cemetery that was really close and right next door to our campground and walk it. I knew I needed to watch what I ate, and I did about 50% of the time. But again, it got boring. I wasn't seeing results fast, and I felt like I had taken like 5 steps backwards from when I grew all that muscle and lost about 15 pounds in our hometown gym in 2013. The walking / jogging thing only lasted about a month, and I gave up because, like I said, I hated it. This is all where my fitness journey started. Copeland and I went out to dinner at a steakhouse one night, and as we were walking out to the truck, I noticed that there was a Planet Fitness sign lit up across the street. Now, we had been in this town for quite a few months, and neither of us had never noticed it. So, as we were driving home, I was telling Copeland how cool these gyms I had heard that they were. You only had to pay $10 without a contract. And my problem is, since we move so much, it's really hard to buy a contract from one gym because the next town that we go to may not have that gym there. So the rest of the evening, I toyed with the notion of joining and trying to do this dieting and exercising thing again. But this time, there was something different. This time, I was fed up. I was fed up with starting over and over and taking one step forward and 12 steps back. I knew what I wanted and I had an idea of how to accomplish it in the gym, but like my past, I knew that if I didn't get my diet on point, that I would just be spinning my wheels again. I knew if I wanted to do it this time, that I needed to do it right. At the same time thinking that, I also felt lost. There were so many things that I didn't know, that I could learn and teach myself how to do this right. I guess I just never really actually thought about it. I wanted that body image in my head to become real. I was tired of feeling down about myself. I really just had enough. I was out of excuses to convince myself that I couldn't do this. That next morning, I woke up, I made myself breakfast, had my coffee, just like normal, and after that, I was on a mission. I put some workout clothes on, and I headed to the gym to sign up. I had no idea what I was going to do as far as exercise or routine. The only thing I remember is feeling unstoppable as I walked through those gym doors, because I knew that this time I was going to get it right, that I wasn't going to let myself fail. I got signed up and I got on the elliptical, and while I was taking everything in from this gym being so nice and so big, I planned out in my head how I could do this. I knew YouTube had become really popular in the fitness industry, and so I reverted to that over the next few weeks. Luckily, I ran onto a couple of YouTubers that had been doing YouTube and fitness for a while. This one particular girl, I went back like 3 years and watched all of her videos. They say you can learn anything off the internet, and maybe it's true because that's where I got all my inspiration from the start of my journey. I eased myself into the nutrition because I knew it was going to be the hardest part for me. I knew I needed to cut, but not cut too much. This is where I buried myself in books. Now, I am not a reader, but because I wanted to learn about this subject so bad, I didn't even realize that I was reading. One website I relied on was bodybuilding.com, and that was because one of the YouTube followers that I was following was a spokesmodel for them. So I knew it was a place that I could go and learn and trust what I was learning. I didn't make myself eat 100% healthy because I knew if I went in head first that I wouldn't make it. I was not at all a healthy eater before, so it was going to be a really big change for me. I focused on eating 70% clean and 30% whatever I wanted, but still not going, you know, like junk food galore. I allowed myself a full-on cheat meal on Sunday, since that was the day Copeland was always off. Now, he doesn't eat healthy, or didn't at the time. So, during the day, I would focus on eating healthy, and because I would always fix him dinner during the week, I wouldn't focus on cooking anything healthy for dinner. I would just simply watch my plate proportion. It eventually got easier eating healthy and not wanting to snack on chips or buy cookies that sat on the grocery store shelves. Once I started learning a little bit about nutrition, my eyes opened to all this fast food and all this unhealthy food that sit on these grocery store shelves. I started caring about what I put into my body. Now, I still wasn't eating 100% healthy, but I was becoming aware of how much food I was eating and how much food I used to put into my mouth. My knowledge about nutrition has just evolved over the last year. I continue to learn and I continue to want to learn to have a better understanding. The same goes with the gym. I knew about working out, but I have learned so much about what exercises do what. I have learned so much about what exercises do what and what you can do for a certain outcome, how you can target individual muscles, what you do not want to do, just the cap on health and fitness is unlimited. I learned something new every day, and I still do today. I have learned so much about my body and what my body can do and what it can't. I've pushed myself to what I thought was my limits and surprised myself that I had more in me. This whole journey has been something where I've learned about myself, whether it's been my strength capabilities or my mind capabilities. It's been a journey about finding myself. I now know who I want to be, and I am very happy with who I am becoming. My outlook on life has changed. My outlook on friends, family, just people in general has changed. I now find myself wanting to help others find their happiness, no matter if it's in fitness or not. I want people to know that the littlest dream can come true. Yes, there's going to be hurdles. It's not going to be a piece of cake, but I can personally tell you, it will be worth it. I want people to experience the embracement, the fulfillment, the joyfulness, the pure happiness, and the courage that comes from within you when you realize that you are unstoppable. Also, the mind capabilities that you realize that you have. I want people to stand in front of a mirror and be able to smile and accept what they see. Healthy does come in all shapes and sizes. The flaws we pick out from ourselves are often our best unique feature. It's taken me this long to realize that, and all of this is how my YouTube channel started. I wanted to show people that they can achieve their goals. I wanted to share the knowledge that I was learning and I'm still learning. I wanted to help people that didn't know anything about the gym, that didn't know about exercises. These past 6 months since I've had my channel has become a memory lane for me. It's a place where I can share my life and come back to and reflect on. I've had to face many challenges throughout this journey. We only stayed in Hobbs for about 4 months, and then we moved to a town called Burlington, Colorado. It was a very small town, and we knew that we were only going to be there for about 4 weeks, and then we were going to move again. Now, luckily, this town had a beautiful park, so that's where I decided that I would purchase some at-home workout equipment so I could continue my exercises and working out. Every morning, I would get up, I would get my gear, and I would go work out. I had to get creative, and I tried to challenge myself. My nutrition never changed, it just kept evolving and I kept learning what worked for my body and what didn't. And I continued to learn more and more. I had stuck with fitness for 4 months in Hobbs, so I wasn't going to let myself quit just because I didn't have a gym. It was like I had like a fire lit under my butt from the results that I got in Hobbs. After those 4 weeks, we moved to another small town, but this one had a small gym. At this point, I was itching to get back into the gym and use equipment that I was used to. I continued to use this gym for about 2 weeks until we took another job here in Florida. Traveling was another challenge for me because if we weren't traveling but like 6 hours, we would only stop about once for fuel and gas. So trying to get my water intake with my small bladder did not work because every time I would drink just a little bit, I would have to go to the bathroom and we would have to stop. I would carry nuts and other healthy snacks, so I was able to snack on while we were traveling since we didn't stop very much. So I always had something with me to curb my appetite. So this is when I joined my current gym I am at right now here in Lake City. It's Anytime Fitness. I have been here for about 6 months, and I absolutely love it. I feel like because we traveled so much my first 6 months, I didn't really get the progress that I wanted to. Since being here in Lake City, I've really had the chance to focus and strive for that progress. I've also met some really helpful people that has helped and challenged me in great ways. This entire last year has been awesome. I now know that dreams do come true. That you are able to get over your many fails and get it right, eventually. I also want to take a short time to thank people. Just because this is my story doesn't mean that I got here all by myself. So if you are a family member, a friend, or a follower on my social media, I want to say thank you. Because of your encouragement, support, and believing in me, I am able to sit here and reflect on my awesome last 12 months. I want to thank my boyfriend, Copeland Cook, for his awesome support. He is the reason that I'm in this situation and I am able to chase my dreams. He's the one that often gave me advice from his former powerlifting days, and he's also the one who keeps my supplements stocked up. Today isn't just about me, but everyone that's had a part of my journey and my success. I truly thank you. Now, I'm going to show you a picture. This is a picture that I recently took after I first started my fitness journey a year ago. And if I could go back and tell this girl that she was going to find her passion, that she was going to realize that dreams do come true, that she had no idea what the future held. She had no idea what she was capable of, how her life would be different in all aspects at this point. If I could go back and tell this girl that 1 year from when she first walked into that gym and walking through those doors made her feel so unstoppable, that she knew that this time that she was going to get it right, that she did get it right, that she did become that person that she wanted to become. People often talk about dreams as if they really aren't real. That if your dream comes true, you're just kind of one of the lucky ones, or you've had it handed to you. I've learned through this journey that this lady on the other side that has accomplished so much and has learned so much about herself, different than this side has. Today I sit here very emotional. This is not a big deal to a lot of people, but because I am so emotional, and why I'm so emotional is because this has been my dream. This has been my dream since high school. I've always wanted to be fit and toned. I've always wanted that body. Today does mean a lot to me. And the only reason why I'm so emotional is because you see how bad I wanted this. How many times I tried, how many times I failed, how many times I just simply gave up because it was too hard. Or at least I thought it was too hard. How many times I tried to go down the path and did it the wrong way or just was lazy. Today I finally can reflect on this past year of me getting it right, to me following my dreams and finding that dream that I've had since high school can come true, and it has come true. So if you're still watching this video, again, thank you. Because if you're watching this video, obviously you're a supporter of me. I knew this video was going to be long, and I tried to make it as short as possible because I myself don't like to watch long videos. But if you have watched up until now, I truly thank you for your support. And I hope you can take something away from this video, because if it's one thing that I've learned through my journey, that inspiring people inspires ourselves. I cannot wait until another year from now and do another video like this, because I know since I've done it for 1 year and all the progress that I've made and everything that I've learned this past year, you know, I know the future is possible now. I know what I can do, what I can't do, and I'm going to strive for it. And I absolutely can't wait for the future. Here comes bad news, talking this and that. Give me all you got and don't hold.